Yes, my people, we've got meal one here in the form of a protein shake. Got 45 grams of protein in with a bit of almond milk. Then we've got meal two, or meal one and meal two. It doesn't really matter how you look at it. And then we've got eggs, four whole eggs with some veggies, and then 3 grams of salt. Bosh.
Good morning, my people, or good afternoon, good evening, whenever you'll be watching this. Welcome back to the Steam Visit YouTube channel. As you can see, it's a very rainy UK day today, which makes me even more excited for Thailand, because it's Thailand prep day eight. I have lost count. I think it's day eight or day seven. What today? To the Tuesday. Yeah, day eight. Plan of action today: number one, coaching consultation call at 11. Number two, haircut at 1 o'clock. Number three, business mentee call at 3 o'clock. Number four, business mentee call at 5 o'clock. Number six, train legs. And in between all that, we'll be editing the previous day's vlog. If you haven't already checked that out, go over. It'll be the prep day minus this one, minus one. As always, we're attacking the hill in the fucking rain. Oh my God. This weather is actually awful. Genuinely awful. Makes me hate the UK even more than I already do. I already want to leave anyway. But the fact that I'm fucking drenched, like, this is horrific weather. Someone's got a fucking umbrella. That's the right idea. But you win some, you lose some, eh, kids? Sometimes you just got to take one for the team. And that's what we're doing today. So if you haven't already attacked your day, start fucking attacking it now. Because I'm out of breath, so I'ma catch you in a coffee shop in a bit.
So meal one is about to go down. We've got some tomatoes, some peppers, courgettes, eggs. Bosh. And then we've got a haircut at half one.
Shout out to my boy Eddie Abu eating the eggs. I feel like a lot of what Eddie Abu says, right, is good, but a lot of it's sensationalized, a lot of it is hyperbole to make sure that people get his message across, and that essentially he builds validity with what he says. Like, at the end of the day, look, some foods are a bit too processed, yes, but will they end up killing you? No. So it's one of them, isn't it? And like, he comes from a background where bodybuilding is very old school in that fashion. And back in the day when he was bodybuilding, he didn't have all of these varieties of food. And to be honest with you, sometimes it is detrimental to people. Like, when you have too much food choice, when you have too much availability, then you literally don't know what to choose. And a lot of the time, indecisiveness and people that lack clarity with what foods they want end up not being able to stick to a plan because there's too many options. They don't know which direction to go in. They don't know which direction to pursue. Do I eat bread? Do I eat which kind of bread? Do I eat fruit? Which kind of fruit? Do I eat protein? Which kind of protein? Which kind of protein is good? Which kind of protein is bad? You know, there's a lot of misinformation in there. You know, and the main thing is making sure that you stick to a plan that you find enjoyable, that incorporate foods that you think you will like, you know. And there's always room for maneuverability. There's always room for aspects to change within your program. Like, say for instance, you are bored of chicken, you can swap chicken for turkey, or you can swap turkey for beef, or you can swap beef mince for steak and stuff like that. You know, you can swap haddock fillet with cod fillet, etc., etc. And same with like carbohydrates, you can choose rice, pasta, potato, bagels. Kind of food that's a single ingredient will always be easily digestible, you know. That's the main thing, and I think that's what really Eddie Abu gets at, is that he tries to get people to focus their minds on the amount of ingredients per product. And to be honest with you, the more ingredients you have per product, the harder your body's going to find digesting them, you know. So he has got a point, but at the end of the day, is 50-50 King's meal fucking shit? It's not fucking shit, it's still food. But there are just better options out there that you can buy that end up probably being a bit more expensive. Like, at the end of the day, raw food, raw ingredient food is always going to be expensive because it's a lot more pure, it's a lot more organic from the source. And I don't mean organic as in like the way that it's produced. I mean, if you have a single ingredient, there has been no level of process or very minimal level of process to that. So yeah, but that's pretty much it. Off I go to meal one. Bye bye.
Hello, babies.
Hello, babies. Are you excited to see me? Hello, waggy tails. Hello. Is a vlog complete without a little pawpaw? Can I have a pawpaw? Thank you. Thank you.
Yes, now, my people, we are back. Your boy has secured the trim. Turkey slap. Just letting the doggos out for a little wee wee. Bless them. There they are. Right, watch this. She goes for a wee, and watch what she does now. Look at this. Ready? Mia's gone for a wee straight away. Sniff, sniff, sniff. Give it 2 seconds. One, two, piss in the exact same spot. Do you know what that is? That is dogs marking their territory. Sandy's gone. All right, I'm the queen around here, so I'm going to piss exactly where you piss, Mia. Fuck you. A little bit of dog knowledge there for you. I can't wait to get my own dog, to be fair. What you got there, Mush? What you got there, Mia? A little sticky? Yeah, a little sticky. Yeah. I don't know when I'm going to get my own dog, but I'll get my own dog eventually. So the plan of action now is we've got a call with Katie, my mentee, at 5 o'clock. I've got the food on the go. Meal three on the go. So we've had a protein shake, we've had eggs with veg, and now we're gonna have beef with rice and veg. Plenty of salt and a banana, and then we're gonna train legs. So I'll catch you guys.
Meal number three, we have beef, veggies, rice with a little bit of tomato ketchup. This is the tomato ketchup I use. Let me show you. This is a lifesaver. 50% less sugar and salt. Okay, as you can see here, 12 grams of carbohydrates per 100 grams. Very, very useful tool when it comes to dieting.
Okay, yes now, my people. First exercise of leg day is going to be a single leg hamstring curl. Okay, so a very important tip with this particular exercise is making sure that you do not lose tension throughout any part of this movement, okay? So, time under tension throughout the entire movement. No jerking, no stopping and starting, no resting anywhere, okay? This is an isolation movement. One, two, aim for 10 to 15 reps. Three, squeeze at the top. Four, see how I'm squeezing all the way at the top here? Five, get that stretch. Six, if you want to lean forward a little bit, you can help get yourself the stretch. Seven, eight, nine. You can see how I've got like a 3 second eccentric going on. One, two, three, up again. So around 4 to 5 seconds of contraction per rep. Ooh, let's go. It's a very nice squeeze.
Very good and nice. I like it a lot. Here in gym, we get big by time and tension. Five, three, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Oh.
And that's how failure, muscular failure, looks like. Fuck. Hyperextension, but the hyperextension can be focused on the hamstrings rather than the lower back. Okay, so you've got it too low, you can be doing erector spina rather than your hamstring. So you want to have the platform right at the top of the quad here, and that's where you're going to get full active range, almost like you're doing like a barbell RDL or a dumbbell RDL. Don't worry, you're not in it, it's fine. Don't worry, you're not in it, it's fine. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, it's for YouTube. Yeah, I chat a lot of shit, but sometimes it's half right, it's all good. As long as I sound confident, I'm all good. So we're aiming for 6 to 12 reps on this one if I can get it. But to be honest with you, this fucking machine is crushing my balls up. I'll be real. Ow. Three. Four. It's also very important that you don't come too high. Okay, if you come too high again, you're going to be bringing in your lower back. Oh, it's fucking good. Oof. Okay. I don't know how many reps that was, but that's exercise two done. Oh, my balls. Fucking hell. That machine's squashing them. Oh, yeah. I'm trying not to squash my balls in this one. So I just want to show you. I'm going to set my jack up so I can show you exactly where that leg placement is. Okay, you see, here, the pad here is literally there's about this much between my ASIS or the V line here to the pad. Okay, so back of your feet firmly on the pad. Try not to crush your balls. Oh, this is becoming a proper issue. I've not got much down there, I promise that. But fucking hell, it's getting awkward. There we go. Perfect. Oh, that's good. Right. Up. There we go. That's. And you want to come all the way down. Fold your arms. Come all the way down. And then up. And squeeze. Really put the pressure through the quads. So you can really push through. And all on the hamstring. Okay. Ooh. There we go. Oh. Right, that's it. That's enough of that. Ow. Yeah, my fucking hamstrings are on fire. Oh, God. Oh. Bloody Nora. That's good shit. Ow. Woo. My people, we have got exercise number one for quads. So, before we go into our compounds, what we're going to do is warm up the joint, the muscle. The joint's a little bit warm already because we've done a bit of hamstrings. But again, we're just going to get the muscle hooking. So, we're just going to aim for about 20 reps on this particular first set, just to get plenty of blood in the muscle, get those muscle fibers working, mobilization, blood flow is going to improve muscle recruitment when the shit gets more difficult. Again, time and attention with your warm-up sets as well, and carry that principle throughout the whole session. I think that's 20. Right, next one. One thing I will say is if you're experiencing any level of pain throughout a warm-up, then don't go heavier. And it may sound like common sense, but a lot of people experience pain and go, oh, if I go a little bit heavier, that pain's going to go away. Wrong. Really work within yourself and the capacity of your muscles, capacity of your joints, because that's when long-term injuries happen. Fucking dropping the knowledge bombs today, aren't I, boy? Right, working set now, boys. We're going to aim between 15 and 20 reps. Once again, time and attention the whole time. Make sure you use these handles. Grip yourself in nice and tight. And it gives you more purchase. Right, let's go. 3 seconds down, 1 second up. Hold, pause at the top. One, two, three, one, one. One, two, three, one, one. Fucking hell, I'm not getting 15 reps here. Woo, let's go. Let's get as many as we can. Oh, fucking hell. Yeah, that was a poor effort. Up. Ah, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, fuck me. If you're not putting faces after you've taken a muscle to failure, you probably haven't taken it to failure, to be fair. Right, same again. Two, three, one, 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 two, three, one, one, two, three, one. Ow. Yeah, deal savage, bro. Thank you.
Right, let's go. Okay, leg press. Let's go, working set, four plates. All right, shoulders, legs, shoulder width apart. Again, time and attention. Making sure we've got at least a 2 second eccentric coming down and then keeping the tension on this quad the whole time. We're gonna aim for 15 reps. If we get less, we get less. If we get more, we get more. Let's go. Fucking hell, boy. Oh, I'm going like a fucking tomato. Ow, ow. Oh, right. Last exercise of the day is calves. Okay, so two quads, two hamstring, one calves. That makes a very, very nice, very lovely leg day. Okay, like I said in my previous YouTube video when I train legs, lots of reps are the key to growing calves, okay? Once you've done a lot of reps, i.e. 60 reps over three sets, then you can do a little bit heavier, go quite heavy and do 6 to 12 reps, okay? Oh, my legs are fucked. Let's go. So we're gonna aim for 20 reps here. Keeping the time and attention, getting that stretch. So when you come all the way down on that ankle, really stretch that calf and then come all the way up and squeeze. And you should have two parts of the movement. So one, and right up to your tippy toes, two. One, two. One, two. Get that stretch, one, two. If your feet slip, don't be afraid to reposition. You want the pressure on the balls of your feet. Oh, that's getting many reps again. Don't be afraid to bounce out of the bottom, get a stretch. That's job done. Fuck off. Nah, bun that, bruv. That's lethal. It's absolutely fucking lethal. Oh, God. It'll grow your fucking calves.
We've got meal number 4 today, which is bagels and whey sludge with some salt on top. Lovely stuff.